All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is U.S. Global Investor CEO Frank Holmes. And Frank, it's always great to have you back, especially on a Monday. How are you, my friend?
I'm well, thank you. And it's a golden week last week.
Yes, that's why you're here, because I thought it'd be a great opportunity to get some insight from you about gold and what's been happening. And people may say, hey, gold's at great, it's finally, you know, doing well. And it's like, but you're here to point out that gold's been doing well for quite some time.
Well, this century, since there's been a push by the G20 finance central bankers, MMT, Modern Monetary Theory, we have witnessed gold outperforming the S&P by 50%. So you just think of them in that context, that really gold did that well. Well, it has also really helped jettison the largest hedge fund in the world, Ray Dalio's Bridgewater, who always has an exposure to gold. But that's a big picture going back the century. So as we come down that funnel approach of looking at what's driving things recently, well, the data points now that we've had 2 years of consecutive central bank buying 1,000 tons of gold. And this has been consistent since 2010, that they've been big buyers, net buyers of gold. So now we get the funnel down outside of central banks and we go smaller and we go to Costco. And Costco, last Thanksgiving, they started selling gold and they've made other disclosure documents. And it's really quite interesting how fast $100 million of gold wafers went out the door, people purchasing gold. And some demographic studies were coming out that were reported that they were predominantly professional Asian women from China and India that have this cultural affinity, which I've always characterized as the great love trade. And that's because 60% of gold demand is for love. It's portable wealth. Protect your family. And I thought it was really interesting that Costco now was talking, it was an article this past week, of $200 million a month of gold bullion sales.
I think people are no doubt surprised, first off, that Costco is actually selling gold. But secondly, the amount of gold they're selling, it really is staggering. Because most people go to Costco to get, you know, 17 of something. But here, obviously, they see the value in selling gold. And if you can buy, you know, detergent and cleaner, why not gold as well?
Yeah, and they've made it easier. You know, in Canada, it used to be Bank of Nova Scotia had a big gold division, and it was easy to buy gold. Now it's more difficult. They sold that after 2010. I believe is, and you see in the U.S. it's very fragmented buying gold. The big go-to site is usually Kitco for people who want to buy gold and deliver it to you. But all of a sudden, it's Costco. And remember, Costco built its backbone on the back of American Express card before they switched to other credit cards. It was predominantly American Express. So the average person that has a American Express card is double the average income. So they have higher disposable income and purchasing a higher value product such as portable wealth gold.
Yeah. Frank, it only seems that the gold price is getting stronger as things go on. And there's obviously for the rest of 2024, I know you can't predict what the price will be, but there are indicators of, I would think, of where gold will be at or where at least it will stay.
Well, I think more and more people, Steve, are starting to wake up that maybe a 10% weighting like Ray Dalio does is prudent and having bigger exposure. What's exciting for Canada, in particular, the junior gold mining stocks. And so they all of a sudden, they start getting a bid because gold hits 2,400. So I think it's probably pretty good from that end for stocks. I think the gold stocks can probably give you more leverage to rising gold. I've always advocated having exposure to both. The golden rule, having 10% exposure, 5% in gold stocks, high quality gold stocks, and in bullion, and then rebalance that every year.
Yeah, it really is truly amazing stuff, especially the Costco part of it. I was reading in prepping for this interview, Frank, that Wells Fargo saying they're selling $200 million worth of gold bars each month. I mean, it really is staggering, and you can see the price of it and where it's at, and makes no surprise that Costco jumps in on it. They tend to get ahead of the game, so to speak.
Yeah, and then you got to think of stores like Walmart. You know, Walmart, if the whole family had stepped together as one group entity with all the trust, they'd be the richest family in the world with $350 billion market cap. But it doesn't show up like Jeff Bezos does and Elon Musk. But one of the other things is, when you think of Walmart, is Walmart is a huge distributor of inexpensive 14-karat gold jewelry. They're the biggest. So what happens when all of a sudden it goes mainstream that you should be buying silver coins and gold coins, and they go through stores like Walmart? I think that will be where gold goes to 3,000. And I honestly believe it should be more at this price level based on the growth of the monetary base since COVID. Gold should be over 7,000.
Yeah. Costco and gold. We learn something new every day. Frank, thanks so much. Great insight as always. And good to see you again.
Great to be with you.
All right. Frank Holmes, the CEO of US Global Investors.